as I share the handout with the school board and have any, help me answer any questions that you guys might have. Make sure you have it.
I can remember this one, Mr. Shea.
We did a lot of work beginning a little over a year ago. We had the idea to rebrand our district with our mission, and I think you'll find that these people that are standing with me, as well as the other names that scrolled across the screen, have been heavily invested. We did something that no one, to my knowledge, has ever done before through communicating with our community, our educators, through social media, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. We've had a unique opportunity to lead the way here in Denton ISD, and I'm very proud to have had the opportunity to work with these folks here that are representatives of those that worked with us, as well as the opportunity to work with you guys and hear the support that you've offered. So with that, I've shared with you our mission. We narrowed it down to 17 words. They were based upon all of the feedback, like the numbers showed at the beginning. We narrowed that down to the 9 most frequent words, which very ironically were 3 nouns, 3 verbs, and 3 adjectives. And we included 6 of those, 2 from each category. It was really remarkable to see unfold. Last Thursday, we worked on our final draft. As you saw, we had 700 some odd emails through the course of that I've kept. Last Thursday, I sent a final message, and Jamie said that who was on the list there of EIC members, that his phone at his conference was going dead because we were responding to one another 109 times on Thursday and Friday. It was a really remarkable sight to behold, to see my phone blowing up there. And it was a very unique opportunity that I was very proud of these people and the investment that they've made in their time. So I'm grateful for the members of our community who've come, our administrators, our teachers, counselor.
Any questions or comments from the board? I don't know how you did it, but I'm very proud of you and of your product. I mean, you know, I don't think people would ever realize how much time and work truly went into this profound statement, but we so appreciate it, and I love what it says. I mean, it pretty much says what that big long thing said before.
There are a lot of similarities. I think that the one word that really stands out is the idea of the local and global community, that our kids are moving into a world where they will live in one community and do their groceries and do their banking, go to church, go to school, and sell their ideas and products all across the world. So they live in both communities at the same time, and it's really becoming one worldwide global community. I think that's unique, but you're right. There are some very close similarities between the two.
One word, one syllable, one consonant, one vowel. Wow.
Aww.
Anybody else?
I don't think it needs many comments.
I never thought the day would come when you would say that. And that's probably a really good
Just real quick to Mr. Shane and to this committee, thank you for the hard work and for really keeping our students first. This Education Improvement Committee, this group of people, made up of all individuals of our learning community, and every parents, businesses, nonprofit, faith-based organizations, that's what it takes to truly make a difference and to truly help our kids grow. We saw all those children that were here as we got started this evening. And they're counting on us to do exactly what this says. They're counting on us to make those things happen. And we appreciate you for helping us get to this point so that we can communicate that to all the members of our community. And then we will come back with these next steps, the vision, the values, and the goals that just fall right in line to doing exactly what we say we're about and why we exist. Mr. Shea, thank you for your work. Thank you for your leadership, and thank you for your risk taking. That's a big jump to just jump out there and do what you did. And this group, I just can't say enough to you all in appreciation for your work and for really keeping the first things first. And that's our kids.
Dr. Rodriguez?
Yes, and thanks for keeping us in the loop. I think throughout the process, you know, I think I for one felt, you know, very much part of the good work that you were doing all along the way. And I was wondering, you know, when you submitted to us the mission statement and some slogan submissions, you know, from the group, how is it that you were able to bring all these different terms and encompass them within this very beautiful statement, succinct statement? I noticed some of the common terms that you had in that early submission to us: responsible, competent, caring citizen of the world, safe, secure, nourishing environment, resilient. All of these were common terms that were in that early submission. And I think all of these are somehow, one way or another, nicely subsumed within this 17-word statement. Thank you again for your good work.